The press said she wept and cried when she was going to the scaffold. And she said something to me just before she died. That was in the press. She never spoke to me.
She came to you?
She came to me as though she was just walking the ordinary way, walked right to me, the trap door where the person has to stand, like a T-mark, and her feet stand in the T-mark, you see. And she never spoke to me. I can see her now, just flicked her eyes, and she just puckered her lips, so she's trying to smile, you know. She's a brave woman.
From the time she came into the dock until the end of the trial, I must admit I was rather surprised, Mary, and I came to the conclusion that she was so certain that she was going to be convicted that she'd made up her mind, she'd got to face it.
How strongly did you get that impression? How quickly after you had seen her?
Well, of course, I saw her as she came into the dock. Then I saw her. I didn't look at her, I must say, hardly at all during the case of the prosecution. Then she came in the witness box, and of course I have to look at a witness in the witness box. You know, one of the things we have to do is try and make out the witness telling the truth. And you have to observe their demeanour. And that sort of thing. And of course I was bound to look at her then. Matter of fact, she was telling the truth, in most respects, I'm sure. Unfortunately, the truth for her was fatal.
I want you to be perfectly cold and clear, and I wanted a cold and clear answer. I wanted the effect of a plea of guilty to the offence by an admission of the ingredients which made up the offence.
And what was that question?
The question, I repeat. When you fired that revolver at close range into the body of David Blakely, what did you intend to do?
And her answer?
Her answer was, it is obvious, I intended to kill him.
Yes, of course I had hope.
Based on what?
Nothing. Me.
Your ability as a lawyer?
Well, I believed so then. I've made a mistake, didn't I?
You see, on the face of it, the phrase an open and shut case is virtually irresistible.
It looked like it, and that was why the police didn't bother too much to trace the story about the gun. Originally.
You believe that?
Yeah. I think they thought they had it in the bag, and that was it.